What is up, squad? It's your Squid. This is my channel, Anxious Squid Productions. If it's the first time you've stumbled across me, hit that subscribe button blindly and decide if you like me afterwards. I'm kidding, decide if you like me first, but then hit subscribe if you do. This video is for my NHL reactions playlist. So now, Artemi Panarin, he was my favourite player this season before the whole shutdown thing happened. Well, I'm not sure if that's true, actually. I think Zibanejad was probably my... Zibanejad and Panarin, that line, if they were ever on together, or the power play for the Rangers and all that sort of stuff. Like, I'm a big Rangers fan. If you could see behind the camera, there's a big New York Rangers flag. I'm keen. I reckon I've seen probably all of these goals, but let's watch them again anyway, shall we? Let's get into it. Thanks for your patience, guys. As I said, if you're not a regular subscriber, please consider becoming one. Hit that subscribe button down there. I'm trying to get to 5,000 subscribers by the end of this year, which is 2020 if you're watching in the future. And if you are watching in the future, just, and I've already hit those goals, you know, just add a bunch to each of the figures, you know, like after I get to 5K. After I get to 5K, I'm going to chase down 10K. And after I get to 10K, I'm going to chase down 25, and et cetera, by certain time frames. So help me out. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and yeah, do your thing. Let's get into Panarin, Artemi Panarin. I've got to admit, when he signed with the Rangers, I was like, I don't know, Russian player. Like, I've still got a bit of that old school. Even though I'm an American immigrant, I've got a bit of that old school, like, oh, I'd rather an American or Canadian, you know what I mean? Like, regardless of how talented they are, fuck knows if he's just going to piss off back to Russia, you know what I mean? So I was a little bit dubious about him. And then about a week after he got signed, he came out and publicly said something bad about Vladimir Putin. And I instantly was fine with him then, because I was like, that cunt's never going back to Russia. Now that he's openly critiqued Vladimir Putin in the American media, he's never setting foot in Russia again. You know what I mean? Like, so I liked him from that point. And then watching him play, like, you'll see here, he's a special player, you know? Bang! Something you'll hear a lot. Sam Rosen. Artemi Panarin! It's a power play goal! I like it. Bang, broken stick.
Why not?
The defender there as well. Oh, have a look at that pass. Good work, Z. Give that, take the A off his chest and give him the C. Far out. Like, he's basically in the goal paint there. Watch. Oh, they were going to show a better angle anyway. That's annoying on my part. Like, he's literally right there. Watch him. He's right in the circle. Gets the pass to the dot. Coming out of the circle. How did he know he was there? Like, I mean, that's good vision. Don't get me wrong. But far out, that's a great apple. Panarin. 1-2. Do-si-do. Let's have a goal. Thank you very much, he says. God, I miss hockey. It's just one of those multifaceted sports, you know, that's like, everything has to go right, and when it does, it looks amazing like that. I mean, I'm pointing that way, but I shouldn't be pointing that way, you know what I mean. Where is he? Right in front of it. How do you give Panarin that much room in between the circles, too? In between the circles, and you haven't even got body on body. What are you doing, champ? He's a foot away from him. How do you leave Artemi Panarin in between the circles while the opposite, like, while his team has the puck? That's just poor, sloppy defence, you know? Nice little breakaway, can't do much about that. My bad, Sabres. Those are my, like, two biggest teams in the NHL. I follow, like, five or six. No, you're not allowed to, but I do, because I wasn't born here. But now I live in Niagara Falls, right? Now I live in Niagara Falls. I live in the Buffalo area. I feel like I should support the Sabres. But the Pegulas, the married couple that owns the Sabres and the Bills, like, in short, they're kind of assholes. You know what I mean? From what I can see, from the way they've been dealing with the COVID pandemic, to the lack of effort on the last couple of trade deadlines and the clear lack of care that their GM of hockey is woeful at his job, you know what I mean? Like, I feel like they're, you know, they capitalise on the fact that the Buffalo market is huge for sports. You know, the Bills and the Sabres, they're going to sell out most games, you know what I mean? So these guys, it's money for nothing, basically, for them, you know? Like, because people are going to keep coming in regardless of whether they put a good product on the ice or the field or not, because it's the Bills, you know what I mean? Or the Sabres, for example, you know? Like, they've got that legacy fandom, you know? Like, it's the team Dad went for, I've got to go and go for them. It's the team Grandpa went for, I've got to go and go for them. You know, I've got to root for that team, etc., right? But yeah, I don't know. I just don't rate the Pegulas as owners, and I feel bad because I want to be a Sabres fan desperately, you know? Like, I've got I don't know why I looked up there, because I've got three jerseys up there. None of them are Sabres jerseys, but I've got an Eichel jersey. I had a Miller jersey. My wife has what's his name? It's like fucking 9,000 syllables from Russia, like Avenegedov or something. Like, something like that, right? She's got that jersey. My daughter's got a Sabres jersey. Like, Sabres should be a part of our thing, but I'd rather follow the Rangers, if I'm honest. Like, not gonna lie. I was in New York City before I was here, but, like, also, I know those loyalties aren't there for, I don't have those location loyalties. I don't have the family loyalties and all that sort of stuff. I'd love to be a Sabres fan because I live here now, but their owners make it hard, was basically what I was trying to say there. I mean, I don't even know who owns the Rangers, so maybe I'm being unfair, but I put it to you that if you went to if you'd never seen a game of ice hockey live, there's an empty netter, if you'd never seen a game of ice hockey live before, in the NHL anyway, like I've seen some Australian ice hockey, but it's like the equivalent of watching the CFL, you know what I mean? Like, or not even the equivalent of watching the CFL in comparison to the NFL, you know? Like, Australian ice hockey, like, I mean, there's rarely any places where ice naturally occurs in Australia, you know what I mean? It's the equivalent of if the the Arizona Coyotes started up a whole league in their state and it was like the third division down. That's about the equivalent of what Australian hockey's like, right? No offense to anyone who's watching this that is an Australian hockey player. Like, you know it's the truth, though. Otherwise, you'd be playing in fucking Europe or America or Canada, right? Like, no offense, but if you think I'm wrong, feel free to let me know in the comments. But yeah, I used to watch hockey back there every now and then. I've been a fan of hockey since the Mighty Ducks, right? And since I had my first ever job, worked in a call center. The guy that worked, the guy that was sitting next to me in said call center, was an expat from Canada. He'd lived in Winnipeg. He was a Winnipeg Jets fan. Which meant that he was an Arizona Coyotes fan at the time, Phoenix Coyotes. And I learned all about hockey through that way. But yeah, came to America. First hockey game I ever saw live was a New York Rangers versus Las Vegas Golden Knights. And I went in thinking, oh, well, Vegas, they're the new team. I might support them. I don't mind Marc-Andre Fleury, you know, like, et cetera, et cetera. And I walked out, a Rangers fan with a Rangers jersey, a Rangers puck, a Rangers, like, it defies logic. If you've never been live to an ice hockey match and you go to Madison Square fucking Garden for your first, you're walking out a Rangers fan. It's just as simple as that. The atmosphere is too electric not for you to at least get like a little zap, you know? Like, it's... I'm a Rangers fan because of the atmosphere in that building that day.
A little separation. And he gets his seventh goal of the season. Al Panarin gets to it. Fast chases it down.
Fast is underrated as well. I'm going to put him on my list, actually. Yes, but Fast. He's severely underrated. He's had a few really, really good apples this year. Finds the biscuit. Gets it to where it needs to be. See, look at him. There was no way that he knew old mate was going to get the pass there. Like, that's not a normal cycle, you know? Like, that's... And so he just follows into the empty space and then flicks it back out in front right into the golden spot where you want it. And Panarin finished.
5-5.
That's a great goal as well. Was quite a screening. Or was he screened by his defense, or what happened there?
Defensive play at the Rangers goal line. They come back the other way. Panarin.
See the slight body on body by Chris Kreider to number 19 of the Panthers there. Watch it. Chris Kreider's coming down in the middle of the ice. Yeah, middle of the ice right now. And so, slight little bump, gets old mate out of the way, bumps him into screening the goalie, I reckon. I reckon he's bumped the defender into the eyeballs of the goaltender there. That's, wait, was that Kreider or was it Fast? Oh, it was Fast. It was Jesper Fast, not Chris Kreider. I thought it was Kreider because it was a big-bodied sort of forward. But yeah, there we go. Just plays into my praise of Jesper Fast being underrated, right? Some people say Jesper, but I'm pretty sure the J is like a... from wherever he's from, you know what I mean? Like it's a Jesper, like a Joanna, or a Johan, or a Scarlett Johansson sort of thing. Like I'm pretty sure it's a Jesper Fast. Because if it was Jasper, it'd be J-A-S, you know? Like some people say Jesper Fast. It's like his name's not Jesper. It's an E, not an A. I'm pretty sure it's Jesper. That was a supreme effort by the goaltender to get over there, but... no chance, Mr. Holtby. No chance. Is that a one time or is he collected and have it? Oh, yeah, no, it wasn't. I mean, it sort of is a one timer, but not really. Nice. I like a big wind up on my one timers, you know what I mean? Like a big fuck off slash. Oh, look at that pass. Who were ya? Who were ya? That's got to be Kreider. That'd have to be Kreider. That pass. Yeah, Strome, bang, have a look at that off the backhand. Just knew where he'd be. That's like the chemistry between those lads.
What a pass from Kreider. Through the legs. Nice lead. Houghton cuts it back. Unieves shot it wide. Houghton in the corner.
Unieves. Great goal, great goal. That's 13. How many? He's got 32 or something. We're not even halfway here. This is good. I like it. Far out, I'm missing hockey. I reckon the Rangers had a small chance at getting to the playoffs this year before the, well, not a small chance, a bigger than small chance of getting there and making it. You know, I feel like they were getting hot. Igor Shesterkin was bloody playing well. Like he's their new goalie from the KHL. Speaking of, by the way, there's a he's really really good mate, and like arguing wise, potentially. The top two goaltenders in the KHL, you know, Shesterkin and Sorokin, I think his name is, but I could be wrong. Just got signed to the Islanders, right? So imagine the heated rivalries they're going to have now. The Rangers and the Islanders with the two KHL leading goalies. Like, these guys are going to be the best two goalies in the comp in a year, 2 years, maybe 3 years. I don't know. Like, they Shesterkin seems to have adjusted really well to the American sized rink, or North American sized rink, sorry. And I reckon it might take the same sort of length of time, like maybe half a season in the Magoos, you know, like, sorry, that's Australian slang, in the twos, you know, like in the reserve grade in the Magoos. And you know, but he'll come up and he'll be on the main roster for the Islanders next season, I reckon. And I'm excited to see the two goalies go at it for the two New York teams, you know. I reckon that'll be fucking cool.
He'll make a spin around the move at the blue line. Here he is, he's going to get the puck.
Oh, that's special. Goalie was screened. He had about a 5 square inch space to get that puck through, and he got it through it. Nice. Kako I was impressed with as well. Like a lot of people said that he wasn't producing enough for a number two draft pick, and that he looked a little bit scared out there. But to me, like, he's playing against men, you know, and he did that in the KHL as well, but it's different ice sizes, different rules, different styles of play and all that sort of stuff. I was really happy with the places he got himself into, with his effort, you know. Like, sure, his body language went down a bit across the years. Across the middle patch of the season there, but I feel like he wanted to surprise people with how good he was, but he'll take a little bit to develop. I still think he's going to be an amazing player, like Panarin, you know what I mean? Like, I think he'll be Panarin quality, just it'll take a couple of years. He's got to beef up. He's got to get a couple of pre-seasons into him, you know? Like, that was just persistence, wasn't it? Just bang, 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 bang.
With his second of the game.
One, two. Oh, it was two. Never mind. I like it when a guy gets his own rebound, though. I reckon that's special.
It didn't look like there was much of an opening. He saw it, and he fouled.
That's crazy. It was a tiny little hole between the glove and the pad. Third career hat trick. Empty net. Nice.
Bring out the hats. It's a hat trick.
Oh man, I feel like I'm going to sneeze, and I just want it to sneeze or fuck off.
And then reacts, and there it is, and here's how easy it is.
Stay in your net, dickhead. That's your fault, buddy. That's what you get. You're a goaltender, not a defender, you fucking dumbass. That's it, my biggest pet hate, you know, and I mean, I know, like, I said in the Mike Smith video I reacted to that I like a puck-handling goaltender. But I like a puck-handling goaltender when he's got a bit of brains about him, you know? Like, Mike Smith wouldn't have done that. If there are players that are converging on you, if you don't know where you're going to pass it after you collect it, stay in your fucking net and don't collect it. You have defenders on the ice. That is their job. Just keep the puck out of the net. Don't try and do extra special shit. Go behind the net, get the puck and pass it to someone, because you end up turning it over and ends up in your net. Just be a goaltender, bro. Be a fucking goaltender. Anyway.
No.
It's the biggest pet hate of mine, you know? Like, just stay in net, asshole. Far out. You let the team down. Have a look, here's another amazing pass as well, though. Like, oh, am I going to shoot? Nah, I'm going to get in it with Z. Zibanejad. I should have guessed, right? Oh, Heedle, that was smart. That's great work. He could have just tried to slap like he was too far down. He wouldn't have been able to have a high percentage shot, you know? He realised there as he was going past the drop, the face-off circle. All I've got to do is get this puck. I've got all the time in the world. No one's near me. Line up. Get the goal. Yes, well done.
The referee was...
Also, controversial opinion. I like the bright orange on Edmonton. Good goal. A lot of people don't like the bright orange on Edmonton. They think they're the worst Edmonton Oilers jerseys ever. But I like them. I think they're good. I like the bright colours with jerseys, you know?
I mean, it was...
Oh, that is special. Again, he's got like a flat puck's worth of size, you know? If it had gone over his shoulder like that, it would have hit the crossbar. Had to go over his shoulder like that. And it did. Oh, yeah. Wow, from his own blue line too. I mean, it's an empty net, but still, that's a fair chunk of distance. Nice one-timer. There's another underrated player, D'Angelo, as well. If they don't give him big, big money and a long-term contract, I will be disappointed. He's a quarterback-style player on the ice, you know what I mean? Like, he can really set up a play, and he's a good defenseman. Perfect defensive defenseman. Exactly the style of offensive defenseman you want. Knows when to get into play, knows when to hang back. Breakaway goal, Panarin. As a goaltender, I'd just probably move out of the way. You know what I mean? If Panarin's coming at me, I'm like, I don't want to look like a dumbass. Just have the goal, son. Like... That's basically what that guy did.
Here's the defensive play.
Fuck, that is good.
Here he goes.
Oh, look at that. Strom as well with the nice saucer pass over the stick of the defender. Watch this. Have a look at this. Little scoop. Scoop over. Like, that's the... That's a perfect, that's textbook. Any kids out there wanting to know what to do when the defender has got his whole flat stick on the ground, just a little tiny chip. It's called a saucer pass because the puck looks like a flying saucer as it's going through the air and then hits flat back on the ground, you know what I mean? You don't want it to spin. You don't want it to be flipping like a knuckle puck because then your old mate's not going to gain control of it again, you know what I mean? You want it just up and over the stick but then back down on the ice. That's, we're going to watch that again. Fuck it. That was a great pass from Dylan Strome. Dylan Strome? Ryan Strome. They're brothers. I can't remember which one's a Ranger. Nice. Here he is again, our boy Fast. I'm going to put him on my list at the end of this, and we'll watch him soon. How's that for a backhand? Stop it, bro. You can't do anything about that. The defender's been on him the whole way. defenders on him. Oh, no, he's playing him pretty loose. Don't get me wrong. Drags it over to his back end and gets it out there. He's playing him loose, but the defender had him since the fucking red line, you know what I mean? So that's just Panarin doing well. Oh, look at that. Far out, that looks pretty, doesn't it? How did it end up being a 2-on-1, though? Who went forward when they shouldn't have? Shooting for the goal there, right? He's shooting for the rebound. He's just going straight into the pad. You can watch him, right? The guy with the puck, he looks to his left. He sees Panarin's there, and he shoots it deliberately low and into the pads to get the rebound goal. That's a very special play from Strome. They had some really good chemistry towards the end of the... Well, I say end of the season. It might start back up. Who knows? But before the lockdown, before the pause... They had developed some really, really special chemistry.
On Timmy Panarin.
We got 3 goals left, I think.
Rocket of a shot.
One board all the way to the other, and then there's a beautiful pass from D'Angelo.
Yeah, board to board. That's D'Angelo, I think.
Stalock, how aggressive he was.
Yeah, bang.
And there's the one pass across. Here's Panarin with one over while Box got tripped up.
Get off him, you fuckwit.
Didn't have much on it.
Great goal. Who was that that got smooshed by the fucking dude, though?
Here's Panarin with one over while Fox got tripped up and let a shot go that didn't
have... Adam Fox? He's my pick for Rookie of the Year, by the way. Adam Fox. I mean, I know he won't win it, but as far as defenders go, offensive defenseman, he had a great first season. As good a first season as any, I reckon.
Puts him right in the middle of the ice.
Harvard. Either Harvard or Boston University grad. Harvard's in Boston? No, Harvard's in Massachusetts. Boston's in Massachusetts. I don't fucking know. I'm horrible with I'm horrible with geography. I'm learning, alright?
Out in front, score! Timmy Panarin!
That's a fucking amazing goal as well. What's this? Look at the pass though, just the scoop, push pass, snooker pass, and Panarin drops in. He's just waiting up near the blue line on his own. That's dangerous as well. Watch Panarin up on the blue line, no one near him, and he's like, I'm just going to watch the play while everyone gets stuck puck watching, wait for it to trickle out and do my thing. Look at him at the top of the screen there. He is all on his own. He is fucking all on his own. He was... Like, in that space, he was, like, on the moon, as far away from anywhere and anyone as possible. There was no one fucking near him up there. That's poor defense. You can't leave Panarin on his own at the point. Oh, special. That's a 30-second goal, and that's it. That's nice. That's this video done. Wow, that was special. Sorry I blabbed so much over it, but yeah, I'm a big fan of Panarin, I'm a big fan of the Rangers, and I'm a big fan of hockey, and I miss it a lot, you know? These right here are players that I'm going to look into based on your suggestions or players that, like in here, where I've gone, oh, wow, actually, I like that guy, like Jesper Fast. He wasn't on the list previously. As you can see, he is now. Jesper Fast is there. That's in blue, obviously. The to-do pile is in blue. The done pile is underneath the blue ones in without a highlighter package, like a highlighter colour on it or anything like that. So if you see your favourite player in that done pile, go and have a watch. It'll be in my hockey reactions playlist. If you don't see your favourite player on that list at all, rectify that. Hit me up in the comments section. I will add them to the list and I'll get to them eventually. If you're worried I'm not going to get to your favourite player for ages and ages and ages, just do what a lot of other people do. Spam my comments section. Every video I ever post, let me know which one you want me to watch and I'll watch it. You know what I mean? Eventually. But yeah, failing that, these guys are my patrons. They're awesome. You could be awesome too. I like money. Converting your money into my money is one of my favorite pastimes. So if you could help me do that, that'd be sick. But yeah, I'm gonna get to more recording. I'm gonna do some more stuff, and I'll see you guys when I look at ya. But I'm not gonna sign off yet. Actually, I've got a Q&A live stream coming later tonight. So get some questions in for me. Currently, I only have like 4, and I would like to have like 40. So get some questions in for my question and answer live stream 2,400 subscriber special. And yeah, failing all that, I'll see you when I look at you. You'll see me when you look at me. Thanks for watching.